Hello, this is Naren motor protection relay for three-phase submersible pumps. So this unit is available in three different models. First model is 3 to 7.5 HP, the second model is 5 to 15 HP, and the third one is 15 to 25 HP. We have three models in motor protection relay. The advantage of using Naren motor protection relay is any existing starter can be converted into a digital starter. Digital starter as in this particular unit will give the safety against the dry run condition, it will give the dry run protection, it will give the overload protection, single phase protection. Apart from that, it will have the three phase digital ammeter and the two phase digital voltmeter. Apart from all these settings, it will also display the kind of error due to which the motor has tripped. So you get all these features by just installing this Naren motor protection relay. We'll first look into the connections. So I'm sure all of you are aware of the Naren single phase preventers, the current sensing preventers. The connections are made similar to our existing single phase preventer. Let me show you our single phase preventer. This is one of the single phase preventers which you might be aware of. So the connections of Naren motor protection relay are similar to the existing preventer. So we have L1, L2, L3 here. This is the incoming load wires. This will be the M1, M2, M3 here mentioned. And then we have C1 and C2, which are again the relay points. This will be given in series with the holding contact. So in the similar pattern, we have the connections for Naren motor protection relay. Let me demonstrate that to you now. So the load carrying wires, the input wires should be given to L1, L2, L3, the first three connectors here. So R, Y and B, the load bearing wire should be given to L1, L2, L3. Next, the motor cables should be given to M1, M2, M3. So these are the M1, M2, M3 connectors. So the load wires or the motor cables will be connected here. Then we have the relay points, C1 and C2. These two are the relay points. So relay points has to be connected in series with the holding contact of the contactor. So I hope the connections are clear. So once these connections are made, any existing starter can be converted into a digital starter, wherein the existing starter will get protection against the dry run, overload, single phase, and with also the error displays. And of course you will be having the three phase current display and the digital voltmeter. Okay, so let us go ahead and have a look at the settings initially. So this switch, which you can see here, press and hold to read. This switch is given in order to read the voltage always. So if you want to see the display anytime, you can press this switch. So I'll press this now, so you can now see the display. So first thing is you will see the voltage, the incoming voltage. This is the two phase voltage again. L and H are the dry run and overload settings. Then on the second line we have three phase current readings. So 00, 00, 00 are the three phase current readings. Since the motor is off now, we'll be having the zero readings. So and yeah, the important thing which we'll have to observe now is L and H settings. You can read it as low and high. So we're just keeping things simple. So as and when you turn on the motor, you can see the current driven by the motor in the second line here. So you will see the current readings in all the three phases. So once you see those readings, H is the overload relay range and L is the lower relay range or the dry run relay range. So the basic concept is the motor will, whenever the water is sufficient, the motor will draw sufficient or will draw minimum ampere according to its rating. So please see the rating or the please see the load which is taken by the motor. So according to this, you will have to set H value to three values more than the load taken by the motor, and similarly L value to 2 to 3 values lesser than the load taken by the motor. Let me give you an example. Let us consider a 7.5 HP three phase motor. So 7.5 HP motor will draw around 15 ampere. So you can just turn on the motor and see the amps driven in all the three phases on the second line. So you have 15 here, just an example again. So you'll be setting H to 15 plus 3, that is 18 amps, and L to 15 minus 3, that is 12 amps. So in order to set the H and L values, what you'll have to do is, H is the overload setting, as I said. You can see the sticker here, H or the overload, you can see the green color knob. All you have to do is take a tester or a screwdriver, gently rotate this towards the left hand side, you can see the value here decreasing. So as I decrease, you can see the H value decreasing. So if your motor is taking around 15 amps, then you will be setting H to 18 amps. So you will be rotating this towards the left hand side to decrease. Similarly, in order to increase the value, you can rotate this to the right hand side. Also, next, once the H setting is done, next we'll have to make the L setting, that is the dry run setting. So since our motor is drawing around 15 amps, what I'll do is I'll have to set L to 15 minus 3, that is 12 amps. So in order to set L value, I'll change the knob here, L or dry run knob, the blue color one. I'll rotate this towards the right hand side to see the increase in number of L. So as I rotate it towards the right hand side, the L value increases. I'll stop it to 12. So rotating it towards the right hand side or the clockwise will increase the value, and rotating it towards the left hand side will decrease its value. So once these settings are made, then we are good. These settings have to be made initially. So, and you need not reset things once you are good to go. Okay. So let me demonstrate you with the motor now. We'll just turn on the motor. So as soon as I turned on the motor, the display automatically lights up with the load current, and then you will not be reading the voltage. If you want to read the voltage, you will always have to press this black switch, or if you remove the switch, the voltage reading goes off. Okay. Then see, my motor is the motor which I am using here is a lower HP one, so because of that it is drawing lesser current, 5 and 6 amps. So in this case, what I'll be doing is I'll be setting H to 6 plus 2. Two numbers is sufficient here. 6 plus 2, I'll be setting H to 8 ampere. 8, and similarly 6 minus 2, that is 4 ampere for L. So once I do these settings, things are fine. So this unit will take care of tripping the motor when there's no water, and similarly tripping the motor when there is overload. Now we'll be generating an overload condition just to see how the tripping takes place. This is the motor on LED. So as I'll be generating the overload condition now. So overload happens whenever the current driven by the motor is more than the set H value. Okay, I'll be decreasing the H value in order to generate the overload. H is set at 3, whereas the motor is drawing around 5-6 amps. So this warning light blinks. This blinks for 12 seconds, indicating there's something wrong in the system or some error is about to happen. So it will wait for 12 seconds and it will turn off the motor. So the motor got turned off now. So if you want to see the reason for tripping, then you'll have to always press this black color switch. So pressing this switch will show you the reason for tripping, overload, and it says 6A. 6A means the motor took the load of 6 amps, because of which the motor was turned off. You have set the value of H to 3 amps, whereas the motor has taken 6 amps. So this sort of diagnosis will be helping us to go about with the problem, in diagnosing the problem. So I hope this overload tripping is clear. Next, we will be generating a dry run condition now. I'll be turning on the motor. So now I'll be generating the dry run condition. Dry run always occurs when the set value, when the value driven by the motor, the load taken by the motor is lesser than the set L value. So what I'll be doing is I'll be increasing the L value in order to generate the dry run condition. So 7 is the value, whereas the motor is taking around 5 amps. So the blinking takes place, that is the warning symbol. This is the waiting time. So dry run tripping time is 8 seconds. So this LED will blink for 8 seconds and the motor will get turned off. If you want to see the reason for tripping, then always you'll have to press this black switch. So it now reads dry run and 5A. 5A is the 5 amps taken by the motor before tripping. So motor always draws less current when there is no water. And similarly, motor draws more current when the voltage is low or when there is some problem with the motor parts. So by knowing the current taken before tripping, we can always diagnose the exact problem. I hope the settings and trippings are clear. We'll also see how single phase tripping takes place. So you can read the current taken in all the three phases. I'll be disconnecting the center phase. You can all observe this reading. I'll be disconnecting the center phase. See now, this became zero. So immediately within 2 seconds the motor got tripped, and the reason for tripping can always be seen by pressing here. See, it says single phase. So whenever the single phase occurs, the motor gets turned off in 2 seconds. So I hope the connections and the operation of Naren motor protection relay is clear. Again, this motor protection relay is available in 3 different models: 3 to 7.5 HP, 5 to 15 HP, and 15 to 25 HP. Again, any starter, any existing 3-phase starter can be converted into a digital starter, as in the digital starter will have the benefits like dry run protection, overload protection, single phase protection, digital 3-phase ammeter, and the 3-phase voltmeter. By we can just use this motor protection relay and convert the existing starter into a digital starter with all the safety measures. I hope this video is clear. You can always contact us for any further queries. You can reach us on 9972243774. I repeat again, it's 9972243774. I hope everything is clear. Thank you so much.